Good morning, my dear students. We are continuing with the chapter data handling. Yesterday we dealt with bar graph. Today we are going to deal with a new topic, that is double bar graph. Hope you understood how to draw a bar graph. The same steps are followed to draw a double bar graph. Let's see the peculiarities of double bar graph. Such type of graphs are known as double bar graph. So what is the difference between an ordinary bar graph and a double bar graph? You can see, for each quantity along x-axis, you have two bar graph drawn, isn't it? For category 1, you have a blue bar graph and a maroon bar graph. So for each category or for each quantity along x-axis, you will have two bars. That is what we call as double bar graph. Double bar graph help to compare two collections of data at a glance. At a glance means when you look at the bar graph, double bar graph, you can compare two quantities. In a double bar graph, for each quantity along x-axis, we will have two bar graphs of same width. That's what I told you. Here, you will have two bar graph of the same width and different height. So, that is what we call as double bar graph. Now, we will see how to draw a double bar graph. This is your question. The performance of a student in first term and second term is given. Draw a double bar graph choosing appropriate scale and answer the following. Students, now see the table here. Here you have three columns, isn't it? Three rows and different number of columns. Here the first row indicates the x-axis quantity. The first row, that is subject, this will be depicted along the x-axis. English, Hindi, Maths, Science and Social. Next two rows, that is first term and second term. The second row you will take as the first bar and the third row you can take as the quantity of the second bar. I told you in a double bar graph you will have two bar graphs for each quantity. So for English you will have a 67 height bar graph and 70 height bar graph. Okay, so the first row indicates the x-axis, second row indicates the first bar and third row indicates the second bar. Is that clear now? Now we'll see the graph. It's already drawn here. Whatever I told you for the bar graph, you should follow here. You are allowed to draw with pencil only. You should not touch your pen in the graph sheet. The first step is to draw the x-axis with an arrow, right x-axis, then draw the y-axis with an arrow, right y-axis, then go to the table. Table is subject. Subject is along x-axis and performance, that is mark. You can write either performance or mark along y-axis. So, I wrote performance along y-axis and subjects along x-axis. What is the next step? You should see what is depicted along x-axis. What is depicted along x-axis? English, Hindi, Maths, Science, Social. So, going to the graph, leave the first square and write English. Then leave the next. Then Hindi, Maths, Science, Social. As you have left the first column vacant, leave alternate columns. Okay, then only it will be good. Now, here instead of drawing one bar in one column, I have drawn two bars. Can you see that? This is the first bar and this is the second bar. That is how you draw a double bar graph. Before going to the double bar graph, the next step in drawing the graph is to choose the scale. Isn't it, children? Choose the scale. For that, what should you do? You should go and check the table again. Here, which is the largest number? Largest number is 95. So, you have to go to the graph and check the multiplication table. Okay, if I take one's multiplication table, what will happen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I will not get 95 here. Isn't it? So, we will go for 2's table. Again, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. You will not get 95 here. Again, 5's table. 5's table also, you will not get 95 here. We will check 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85. You are not getting 95. So, the next multiplication table is of 10. I have wrote 0 here. Then 10's table we will get easily. So, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So, the step of choosing a scale is over. Which scale did you choose? 10's multiplication table. The next step is to write it here. Scale. 1 unit is equal to 10 marks. Isn't it? Marks is given in your table. So, 1 unit is equal to 10 marks along y-axis. That is what we plotted against y-axis. Now, you have finished first part of your graph. That is, you have drawn the x-axis, you have drawn the y-axis, you have written what is depicted along y-axis and x-axis, wrote what is along x-axis, chose the scale of the graph. Now, first part is over. Next is, go to the table, see the English marks. First term 67, second term 70. So, half of the column will be of the first term and the next half will be the second term. 67. Students, this column or this square starts from 60 and ends in 70. Each small line, each thin line is counted as 1. So, you can see 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67. This is 67 and this is 70. Similarly, I have drawn all the marks here. 67, 70, here 72, 65. Here, 88, 95. From the figure itself, you can understand the readings. Instead of going back to the table, you can read it from the graph. Okay, this is how you draw a double bar graph. Now, you should distinguish between first term and second term. So, I have left the first term as vacant and second term I have shaded it. Okay. In every subject, the second term I have shaded it in the same manner. Same manner. Okay. If you are shading it in this way, all the second term should be shaded in the same way. Then you have to write it here. The vacant bar is of first term and the shaded bar is of second term. Now you will get the full marks for your double bar graph drawing. Is that clear, children? Now, you have some questions in your table, isn't it? In which subject has the child improved his performance most? So how will you check? In which of the portion it is more? Here 5 plus 2, 7. Here also 5 plus 2, 7. So Hindi and Max. Hindi and Max. Here also 7 is there. Here also 7 difference is there. So here Max is the subject in which he has improved. Why Hindi we didn't consider? It is not improvement. In first term he had 72 and second term he lost 7 marks. Here he gained 7 marks. Here he lost 7 marks. So in which subject has the child improved his performance the most? Max. In which subject is the improvement the least? Least means smallest. Here improvement is 3 marks. Here improvement is 4 marks. Here improvement is 2 marks. So which is the minimum? Social. So the answer is social. Has the performance gone down in any subject? Yes. Which subject? Hindi. In Hindi, the student got more marks in first term and less marks in second term. So the performance has gone down in Hindi. Okay children, this is the method of drawing a double bar graph. Next, I have to talk about your art integration project. Let's see the topic art integration project. For class 8, your topic is survival. Survival, and for maths, in that part, you have tabulation and graphical representation of monthly corona statistics in Kerala and Himachal Pradesh. Students, according to CBSE, we have a paired state for Kerala and that is Himachal Pradesh. Art integration project is combining Himachal Pradesh with Kerala. So here we are comparing the corona statistics of both Kerala and Himachal Pradesh. You can compare the infected person's number, survival rate and death rate. Now you have learned how to draw bar graph, double bar graph, and in the previous years also you have learned the same thing. So you can use pie chart, double bar graph or simple bar graph to show the graphical representation of this corona statistics. Reading is clearly given in the internet. Just type corona statistics of Kerala and corona statistics of Himachal Pradesh. Now, how is the art integration in this? Art integration, you can do it in the form of PowerPoint presentation. PowerPoint presentation in the sense, you have to prepare the slides showing the graph, the corona situations in Kerala, Himachal Pradesh. You can collect the photos, prepare slides, minimum 10 slides, then present it. Send the video of your PowerPoint presentation. I'm talking about presentation. You should be there. You have to present the slide. Only English is allowed. Don't use Malayalam when you present the PowerPoint presentation. And your submission date is on 28th December 2020. Students, PowerPoint presentation is what I'm showing now. You can do the same thing here also. Prepare the slides. Use this app. My app, you can see it's screencast-o-matic. You can record your voice with the slides. Hope you understood the topic very clearly. So, submission date is 28th December 2020. Thank you. Have a nice day.